Hey guys, welcome back. This video is all about how to add appointments to the Angular scheduler of Syncfusion. I hope my last video helped you to configure the Syncfusion Angular scheduler in a very easier way. Well, I simply displayed a plain and empty scheduler in that. So now let's see how to add appointments to it. To simply define the term appointments, I can say it to be anything that are scheduled for a specific time range in the scheduler. So, it plays a major role in managing your time. In this tutorial, let's see how to bind the appointments to Angular scheduler by passing them either as a local JSON data or remote data service. Alright, before looking on how to bind the appointment data, let me give you an overview of what are the advanced event handling options available on Angular scheduler. Well, you can easily perform CRUD operations on any kind of appointments of Angular scheduler using Data Manager. That is, you can easily add or edit or delete your appointments as and when you require from the scheduler. The Data Manager is one such component offered by Syncfusion to support such CRUD data manipulation with the help of different data adapters. Other than the normal CRUD actions, you can also select and delete multiple events at a time. Simply select multiple events all at once by holding the control key and simultaneously click on the events that you want to delete and press the delete key. You can delete multiple events all at once. And next comes the recurring option. The Angular scheduler has its own built-in recurrence editor to manage such recurring options. Well, next thing is event customization, which is made much simplified with the template option that we'll look on to in detail in my later videos. You can even display the appointments on your own time zone as well by setting the proper time zone for the Angular scheduler. Here I have set UTC time zone for Angular scheduler, so the appointments will display based on the UTC time difference. And you can also display tooltips while hovering over the appointments to display some additional details about the appointments. You can also make specific appointments to render in a read-only mode so that you can't edit that appointment in any of the case. So you can see here, the edit and delete options are disabled for this read-only events. You can also block specific time intervals with the help of blocked events. There are much more you can perform on appointments, and I would like to end up this list here with the last thing. Well, if you want to restrict the time cells to accept only one appointment per time slot, then yes, it is possible to achieve it using the built-in methods available on the Angular scheduler. However, I am not going to cover all these items in this video, but I have chosen some of the important ones to discuss here. For other items, I will share the documentation links at the end of this video from where you can refer them. So in this video, we'll see how to pass the appointment data either as a local JSON data or through remote service URL. I'll also list out few appointment options like how to make specific appointments read-only as well as how to block the specific time slots. And few additional items like how to set default values for the appointment fields and how to change the title of the field labels in the editor window. If you want me to cover any specific scenario of scheduler appointments in detail, then share me your thoughts in the below comment section. That would really help me to consider on my next videos. As we already learned in my last video, how to create and configure Angular application, as well as how to add Angular scheduler to it. So I'm directly starting with how to add appointments to it. You can refer the initial getting started steps from my last video. Open the app.component.ts file, and now let's add a local data source to the scheduler. So as a first step, import and define the event settings model from EJ to Angular schedule package. Now define a variable of type event settings model and assign the array of event objects with valid event fields like start time and end time, which is enough to create an empty appointment. Now assign this data source object to the event settings property of scheduler. So I have assigned the event object variable to the event settings property of Angular scheduler. Run the application with the command ng-serve --open. Now you can spot the appointment on the given time range from 4 to 6 a.m. As you can see, this appointment doesn't have any subject value. So you can provide it by defining the subject field with a proper summary. I'm going to enter the text testing for subject field and then save it. And now you can view it over the appointment here, the same subject value which I have given in code. If you want to make this particular appointment as an all day event, then simply define the property isAllDay as true, and you can see the appointment at the top section near the date header. This all day event indicates that it has been created for the entire day. Now, if you want to make an appointment to repeat for a certain period of time, then you need to set the recurrence rule property with some valid rule string. Let me comment this isAllDay property. Here I have defined the recurrence rule property with valid rule string, which means that this particular appointment is going to repeat on a daily basis for the next 10 occurrences. Let me switch on to the month view to have a better look. So here you can see the appointment has been repeated for the 10 number of days. Now let's see how to make this particular appointment as a spanned event. For this, let me comment the recurrence rule and extend the end time value to 19. So this particular appointment is going to begin by 17th January and it will end by 19th January. And you can see the appointment getting displayed in the all day row that spans from 17th January 2019 to 19th January 2019. Now let's see how to make this particular appointment as a read-only appointment. You can see here the edit and delete options are enabled for a normal kind of appointments. But when I define the isReadOnly property as true, and if I click on this appointment now, you can see the edit and delete options are disabled for such kind of appointment. So any of the CRUD operations will not be able to perform on this particular appointment. Now let's see how to block specific time range with the help of blocked events. This is so simple as I need to simply define the isBlock property as true. I'm just changing it to the previous date for the end time and saving it. So which means that I'm going to block the time range from 4 to 6 a.m. And here you can see the time range from 4 to 6 a.m. has been blocked and you cannot access any of the cells behind this particular time range. This is all about how you can add appointments to the Angular scheduler control. And another important thing to know is how to bind the scheduler data with different field names. You can see that every event object holds the default field names such as subject, start time, end time, and so on. Suppose you need to define the subject field with the name summary. This is possible by mapping the field names through code. Let's see how to do that. So for this, you need to define the fields property with valid field mapping names from the data source. Here, I'm going to give the subject field name as event title, and therefore my data source object should replace the subject field name with event title. And the same as start time replacing with event start and end time replacing with event end. Just I'm commenting this isBlock now. You can see the appointment displayed on the Angular scheduler now. In case if I have not provided this fields property, and suppose you have provided such unusual fields, then you cannot find the appointment on the scheduler. So the proper field mapping should be done for the successful rendering of the appointments on scheduler. Now let's see how to set default values for some of the valid scheduler fields. For example, if you miss to include the subject value for an event, like the event title has been set to blank, then you can set some alternative default values to be displayed on its place. In this case, you can provide the default option for subject field. So here I have provided the default option as hello environment. Now in the absence of the subject field value, the default option value will be displayed over the appointment. You can also change the labels of the fields in the editor window. By default, you can notice that the title, location, start, end, such kind of labels are displayed for the fields of built-in editor window. In case if you want to change this particular text, you can define the title option with the relevant text, and now you can see the text replaced with your provided value. These are the basic things every user should know while trying to add appointments to a scheduler. Now let's see how to add remote data source to the Angular scheduler. In case of binding remote data source to Angular scheduler, you need to make use of Data Manager. Let's see how to use Data Manager. As a first step, you need to import the Data Manager and the required adapters from EJ2 data repository. Then you need to define the Data Manager with its properties URL, adapter and cross domain. So in the URL, I'll be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the appointment data through post action and then bind the resultant data to the Angular scheduler. So now I need to assign this Data Manager instance to the data source of scheduler. So I am removing this JSON object and replacing it with the instance of Data Manager. Also, I don't need this fields property here, so I am removing it, as the appointments of this service is available from the date that lies in the month of June 2017. So I am changing the current date of scheduler as well to view the appointments at the initial load. Make sure the variable of type event settings model is assigned to the event settings property of scheduler. And now save your application. Here you can see the scheduler loaded with the appointments retrieved from the remote data source. So it's just simply a two-step process, defining the Data Manager with the proper URL and then assigning that particular instance to the event settings property of Angular scheduler. Only additional thing is you need to import the Data Manager and the required adapter from EJ2 data repository. So I am ending this appointment topic here. To summarize what we have seen so far, we had an overview of some of the advanced event handling options. After that, we have seen how to add appointments to the Angular scheduler by passing them as local JSON data as well as remote data service using Data Manager. We have also seen some of the additional options available within the event settings. If you really enjoyed and find this video to be useful, then give it a like and subscribe to our channel as well. There are more customizations available on scheduler appointments. So if you are in need of any such customization, let me know in the below comments section, which I'll try to cover in my next video, or I can post you with the help links for your requirement. Thank you for listening to this video and stay tuned with us, as I have planned to cover the advanced options available in drag and resize actions of scheduler appointments in my next video. Thank you.